हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज ज्योत्सना तिवारी एंड वेलकम टू टुडेज डेली करंट अफेयर्स सेशन वेयर वी विल डिस्कस ईच एंड इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट्स रिगार्डिंग योर अपकमिंग एग्जाम. ओके गाइस, सो लेट्स हैव डिस्कस दैट विच टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन विल राइज इन योर एग्जाम एंड फ्रॉम विच टाइप ऑफ न्यूज दैट क्वेश्चन विल मेक और राइज इन योर एग्जाम. ओके, सो डोंट वेस्ट द टाइम एंड हेयर इज द फर्स्ट न्यूज ऑफ टुडेज सेशन. बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस सेशन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी चेंज माई पेन कलर, देन वी विल डिस्कस ईच एंड एवरीथिंग इन डिटेल्स. ओके गाइज, सो हेयर इज द फर्स्ट न्यूज ऑफ टूडेज सेशन एंड द न्यूज इज दैट इंडिया रैंक्ड, हेयर यू कैन सी दैट इंडिया रैंक्ड 105th इन द 2020 ग्लोबल इकोनॉमिक फ्रीडम इंडेक्स. ओके, सो हेयर यू कैन सी दैट वी टॉक अबाउट इंडिया. लेट्स हैव डिस्कस सम इम्पोर्टेंट की पॉइंट्स रिगार्डिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर न्यूज. So here you can see that the India has ranked 105th on the Global Economic Freedom Index 2020. India has fallen 260 places, having been ranked 79 in last year's ranking. If we talk about, so Hong Kong topped in this ranking. It was followed by the Singapore. That means first one is Hong Kong, second one is Singapore. Okay, and India's rank is 105th. What is the main characteristics behind this particular news? So let's have discussed. The report states that the increasing economic independence in India depends on the next generation of reforms in markets and greater opens to international trade. Okay, India's reported as a slight reduction in government size from 8.22 to 7.16. Okay, freedom to trade internationally from 6.08 to 5.71. Legal system and property rights from 5.17 to 5.06, and the regulation of credit labor business from 6.63 to 6.53 granted. If we talk about China, so China is ranked 124th by this ranking. Okay, so which are the top 10 countries in this particular ranking? So here you can see these are the top 10 countries. First one is Hong Kong, second one is Singapore, then New Zealand, then Switzerland, then America, Australia, Mauritius, Georgia, Canada and Ireland. So guys, most of the time the question will rise on our exam regarding top 5 countries and top 10 countries. That means you will have to learn these top 10 countries. Okay, so here you can see economic freedom of the world. So the World Economic Freedom 2020 annual report has been prepared by the Fraser Institute of Canada. This report has been released in India in association with the Center for Civil Society, New Delhi. Okay, guys. So these are the important points which we have already discussed in this particular news. So let's have discussed that which type of question will rise on our exam regarding this particular news. So here is first question which will definitely rise on our exam, and the question is that India ranked what is the India's rank in Global Economic Freedom Index? Question will rise on your exam that what is the India ranked in the Global Economic Freedom Index 2020? Then your answer will be 105th. Okay. Second question will rise on your exam that regarding top 5 country. That means what is the name of that country which is on top in the Global Economic Freedom Index 2020, then your answer will be Hong Kong. Second one is Singapore. Third one is New Zealand. Switzerland is fourth one. And the fifth one is America. Okay, guys. And these top 5 countries, you will have to learn the name of these top 5 countries. Okay. Here you can see the World Economic Freedom. World Economic Freedom Index. Okay. This report is prepared by the Fraser Institute of Canada. Okay. You will have to remember, the question will rise on your exam that which organization published this report or prepared this report, then your answer will be Fraser Institute of Canada. Okay. So I hope you'll understand each and everything in details. If you have any doubt, then you can ask me in the comment box. Here is the next news of today's session, guys. And the news is that MORTH, MORTH conducted the orientation and training program of the iRED app. Okay. So here you can see, let's have discussed some key points. So here you can see that the Ministry of Road Transport and Highway, okay, this is the abbreviation of MORTH. Okay, Ministry of Road Transport and Highway conducted a two-day orientation and training program on the iRED app on 7 and 8 September for selected districts of Karnataka and on 10 and 11 September 2020 for some districts in Uttar Pradesh. Okay, so what is iRED app? Let's have discuss. The basic iRED app has been developed. The app will be customized, integrated as per the requirements of the respective states or UT. iRED's mobile app is currently available for the Android platform and will be available soon for the for other platforms such as iOS, that means iPhone. Okay. Also, this app will enable police, transport, health, etc. So these all sectors are included in this particular app. Stakeholders to use their mobile phones to collect accident data on the spot. Okay. So the data does collected can be used for various purposes such as detecting accidents and the remedial measures to improve road infrastructure, recording accident data for the use of police, health services and other related departments. Okay guys, so we have already discussed that which type of news. Let's have discussed that which type of question will rise on our exam this, regarding this particular news. So here is first question which will be definitely rise on our exam, that recently iRED app has been launched. So this app is launched by which ministry? Then your answer will be Ministry of Road Transport and Highway. Okay. Second question will rise in your exam, that this iRED app has been developed for the which purpose? Then your answer will be for the connection. Okay, for the, to contact or available for the enable police, transport, health etc. All these sectors human can reach easily. So for that this app is basically built. Okay, here you can see each and every point which we have already discussed in detail. One more question which will definitely rise on your exam, please you can see here on your screen, that on app iRED app on 7 or 8 and 8 September for select district of Karnataka and the Uttar Pradesh. You will have to learn both these state name. Okay guys, so we have discussed. I hope you understand each and everything in details. Here is the next news of today's session, and the news is that International Day for the South Cooperation was observed on 12th September. Okay, so let's have discussed some key points regarding this particular news. So the main objective of South Cooperation is to extend to the self-reliance of developing countries so that they can enhance their creative capacity to find solution to their development problems and to explore technological capability. What is the objective behind this particular news? So let's have discussed. South Cooperation aims to strengthen and promote collective self-reliance through to exchange of experience between developing countries. It focuses on identifying and responding to the problem and needs to lead development developed countries, developing countries, small island, developing states, and to enable them to gain greater participation in the international economic activities. Okay. What is the history behind this particular day? So let's have discuss. South Cooperation of India United Nations began in 1949 with the establishment of the United Nations Technical Assistance Program. Okay, by the Economic and Social Council and the creation of the United Nations Development Program in 1965. In the year 1974, the United States General Assembly supported to establishment to promote technical cooperation between developing countries. This day was originally celebrated on 19th December. The date of September 12 was chosen by states in 138 countries to adopt the Buenos Aires Plan of Action in 1978 to promote and implement technical cooperation between developing countries. Okay. Actually, this is the abbreviation of BAPA, B-A-P-A. Okay, guys. So, we have already discussed each and every point regarding this particular news. Let's have discussed that which type of question will rise in our exam regarding this news. Okay. So, here is first question which will definitely rise in our exam. And the question is that International Day for South Cooperation observed on which date? Then your answer will be 12th September. Okay. What is the objective of this day? Then your answer will be South aims to strengthen, okay, Here you can see that the aims to stand to promote a collective self-reliance through the exchange of experience between developing country. Remember, developing country. Okay, it focuses on identifying and responding to the problems and the needs of least developed country, developing country, small island developing states, and the enable to the to them to gain greater participation in international economic activities. Okay, if we talk about South cooperation, so this if question will rise on our exam that the South cooperation of the United Nations began in which year, then your answer will be in 1949. Question will rise on our exam that what is the abbreviation of UNDP, and definitely question will rise in our exam regarding the abbreviation of UNDP. Then your answer will be United Nations Development Program, which was established in 1965. Okay, if we talk about UNGA, so UNGA abbreviation is United States General Assembly, and the establishment year of this particular UNGA is 1974. Firstly, this day was celebrated on 19th December, but the date of September 12 was chosen by the 138 member countries, okay, which is adopted by the Buenos Aires Plan of Action in 1978 to promote and implement technical cooperation between developing countries, okay. So, I hope you'll understand each and everything in details, guys. If you have any doubt, then you can ask me in the comment box. Here is the next news of today's session, and the news is that Lok Sabha passed the National Commission for Homeopathy Bill 2019. Okay, so let's have discuss some key points regarding this news. So here you can see that the National Commission for Homeopathy Bill 2019 has been passed by the Lok Sabha today. The purpose of this bill is to ensure the availability of high quality medical professionals for homeopathic treatment. Earlier, the bill was passed by the Rajya Sabha on 19th March 2020 during the budget session. Okay, so what is National Commission for Homeopathy Bill 2019? Let's have discuss. The bill was introduced in Rajya Sabha by Shripad Yeso Nayak, Minister of State for Ayush, on 7th January 2019. It seeks to repeal to Homeopathy Central Council Act 1973. What is the silent feature of this bill? So here you can see the bill established the National Homeopathy Commission consisting of 20 members to be appointed by the central government. State government will set up the state medical council for homeopathy at the state of level within 3 years after the bill is passed. So what is the function of the National Commission of the Homeopathy for Homeopathy? So here you can see that the formulating policies to regulate medical institutions and homeopathic medical professionals, the evolute for human resources and infrastructure requirements related to healthcare. The bill suggests a uniform national eligibility come entrance examination for admission for undergraduate homeopathy education. The bill purpose to general final year national exit test for students to obtain in a license to practice. Okay guys, so we have already discussed each and every point which is important for your upcoming exam. So let's have discuss that which type of question will rise on your exam regarding this news. So here is first question which will rise on your exam, that okay, there are not much question will rise on your exam, only a few questions will rise on your exam. The first question is that the Lok Sabha passed the which bill 2019? Then your answer will be National Commission for Homeopathy Bill 2019. Okay. Who introduced this bill in Rajya Sabha? Then your answer will be Shripad Yeso Nayak. Who is the Shripad Yeso Nayak? Then your answer will be Minister of State for Ayush. Okay. Homeopathy Central Council. Okay. This bill is introduced in which act? Then your answer will be Homeopathy Central Council Act 1973. So we have already discussed each and every point which is important for your upcoming exam. Okay guys, so here is the last news of today's session, and the news is that Hindi Day is being celebrated all over the country. Okay, so here we talk about, let's have discuss some key points. So here you can see that the on 14th September 2020, Hindi Day was celebrated all over the country. Ghatak Sabha, okay, adopted Hindi written was a Devanagari as the official language of the country in 1949. Currently, Hindi is one of the most spoken language in the world. So, what is the background of this particular day? Let's have discuss. The Constituent Assembly adopted Hindi as one of the two official languages of the Republic of India. On 14th September 1949, which was the 50th birthday of Behar Rajendra Simha, okay, his efforts worked and Hindi was adopted as the official language. This decision of the Constituent Assembly came into force on 26 January 1950. Under Article 343 of the Indian Constitution, Hindi is written as the Devanagari script. India has 22 scheduled languages in all, and only one of 22 languages in Hindi is officially used at the union level. What is Article 343 subsection 1? Let's have discuss. Article 343 subsection 1 of the Constitution states that the official language of the Union shall be Hindi as Devanagari script. The form of numerals used to the official purpose to the Union shall be international form of the Indian numerals. What is official language? Let's have discuss. The Constitution of India is specific to official language. Okay, remember this line. The Constitution of India is specific to two official language, Hindi and English. Business in the Indian Parliament is done in Hindi or English. English is allowed for parliamentary proceeding, communication between the judiciary and the central government of and the state government. Okay, so these are the key points regarding the Hindi Day. Okay, National Hindi Day. So let's have discuss that which type of question will rise in our exam regarding this particular news. So here is first question which will definitely rise on our exam, and the question is that Hindi Day is observed or celebrated on which date? Then your answer will be national. Here we talk about National Hindi Day. Okay, then your answer will be 14th September 2020. Okay, second question will rise on our exam that first time Hindi as a Devanagari official language adopted in which year? Then your answer will be in 1949. Okay. Next question will rise in our exam that the recently on 14th September 2020 Hindi Day was celebrated. Here is the one line which is very very important for your upcoming exam, that the Behar Rajendra Sinha, his efforts worked and Hindi was adopted as official language. That means the 14th September, which is celebrated as the National Hindi Day, this celebrated on the behalf of the Behar Rajendra Sinha. Okay, and on the 5th birthday of the Behar Rajendra Sinha, on the 5th birthday 50th okay sorry 50th birthday of the occasion of the 50th birthday of Behar Rajendra Sinha, this day was celebrated, okay, as the National Hindi Day. If we talk about constitution assemblies, so here you can see that Constituent Assembly came into force on 26th January 1950. Under Article 343 of the Indian Constitution, Hindi is written in the Devanagari script, okay. So guys, we have already discussed each and every point which is important for your upcoming exam. So let's have discuss. We already discussed that which type of question will rise in our exam regarding this particular news. Okay. Yeah, one question which will definitely rise in our exam, that how many official or how many scheduled languages is in the Indian Constitution? The question, always question will rise in your exam regarding this line. Okay. So you will have to learn that there are 22 scheduled languages in the Indian Constitution. Okay. So that's all for the today's session. I hope you'll understand each and everything in details, guys. Here you can see the screenshot of the quiz. So basically, I want to say that if you guys, if you want to give the quizzes on the daily basis, so for that you will have to go to the Google Play Store, download the entry app now, register your mail ID or phone number, and you can give the quizzes on the daily basis. Okay. When you will give the quizzes on the daily basis, so according to that, you can analyze yourself that where are you standing right now. And according to that, you can boost your preparation. Okay, guys, you can also visit our YouTube channel. For that, you will have to go to the YouTube, type the Banking 2.0. subscribe the channel and don't forget to tap on the bell icon. Okay, and also guys, don't forget to like, comment and share this session as much as you can. You can share this session with your colleague, relative, friends, whomever you are study right now. Okay, you can share this session also your social media group, like your Facebook group, your Telegram group, your WhatsApp group, wherever you are available, you can share this session as much as you can. So guys, don't forget to like, comment and share this session as much as you can. Thank you very much for cooperate with me. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.